checking with historian of the former Storm Pay.com series.
Well, moving way back.
Stepping over to the Neesmith now.
Not Neesmith,
Nance Durance Lane Chevrolet Super Series, part of the Great Racing U.S. Series. Yeah, we had to step back there, Roby. I remember that old Storm Pay series, especially down at Golden Isles, the initial race. Way back in the day.
Still bouncing on your daddy's knee back in those days.
Yeah, I was probably, I think that was the, I might have been 12 or 13 by that time there, Roby. But yes, I was actually in attendance at the very first race of this very, well, part of the sanctioning body. So there we go. First car out in the number 41 Capital race car. Clements Race Engines under the hood out of Ackworth, Georgia. It's the Ackworth Assassin of TJ Reed. And coming up behind him in the Massey Electric, Blunt Motorsports entry out of Maryville, Tennessee. And the 4T Machine already got a few Southern All-Star wins under his belt. It'll be Tommy Kerr, and TJ Reed clocks in with a 17.528. Here comes Tommy Kerr going to the top of the board. 17.127.4, the Maryville, Tennessee driver. The Assassin laying it down out of four. Can he go up there? He picks it up, but not enough. A 17.324. And Kerr brings it down. 17.436 on lap two for him. So Tommy Kerr beating Tanner English's practice time by a tenth of a second. So still a lot of grip in the track. Next car out of Loudoun, Tennessee in the Rocket XR1 machine in the number nine. It'll be Corey the Hedgecock. And coming up behind him out of Colbert, Georgia, the pride of Colbert. And the 1C machine, it is Kenny Collins. Hedgecock, no stranger to victory lane, multiple time winners over the last few races, including the World of Outlaws the other weekend at the 411 Speedway. He goes third quick with a 17.856 on his first go around. Collins, a 17.874 on his first go around. Hedgecock all alone in Highside Manor, bringing it down the straight. Does not pick up a 17.862, just a tick off. Kenny Collins picked up, though, to a 17.672 on lap number two. For Kenny Collins. Next machine out in the 111 out of Sylvester, Georgia is Steven Roberts. And powering up behind him in the one of the Double Down Motorsports entries in the number 50 machine, it'll be Robbie Moses. So green flag is out for our two combatants for Sunoco Race Fuel Time Trials. .17864 for the 50 machine of Moses. 17.435 going third quick for Steven Roberts. South Georgia driver going to third quick. And a 17.906 for Robbie Moses on his second go round. Next machine out. And the number 20, sitting third in the Southern All-Star Series points in the number 20 machine, it'll be Ray McElhiney. And pulling up behind him out of Mississippi is gonna be Mark Dotson. Dotson is second in Southern All-Star Series competition. So we're gonna see how Dotson can handle the big 4/10 mile speed plant. .18356 for McElhiney on lap number one. Dotson at .18660 on his first go around. So McElhiney repping for the Southern All-Stars coming down the straight. .18381, a nice little pickup for McElhiney as he goes seventh quick. Dotson picks it up, but not enough. 218.553. Bump qualifying is underway as the top five positions have been filled so far. But we still got a couple of cars to go. And the first of two in the Sunoco Race Fuel time trials. The man on the bubble is Corey Hedgecock with a 17.856. That'll be the time to beat. Next machine out of Spring Hill, Tennessee. And the Bruce built Rocket XR1 out of Spring Hill, Tennessee is Midnight. Brad Skinner, former Southern All-Stars, rookie of the year, and the man coming up behind him, one of the legends here in East Tennessee. It'll be Craig Greer in the 7G. So Brad Skinner clocks in with a 17.943 on lap number one for him. 18.461 for Craig Greer on his first go around. Skinner just knocked Hedgecock off. He goes to fifth quick with a 17.843 for Skinner. Craig Greer, 18.469 on his second go round here on the Speedway. There you go. Next machine out of Fayetteville, Tennessee, leading the Southern All-Stars Series. Points in the cruise with the champions, dirtondirt.com. Rook of the Year leader, it is Jay Scott and the man coming up behind him. And the Double Down Motorsports entry, Longhorn chassis number 21 machine is gonna be the big buck of Shannon Buckingham. So Shannon Buckingham made it into that illustrious field at Eldor Speedway for the Dream 100, the $100,000 to win race, the richest race in the country. So Jay Scott comes eighth quick so far with 18.028 on his first go around. Nice lap for Shannon Buckingham, seventh quick with a 17.864. Jay Scott goes to fourth quick with a 17.584 for him. And not enough for Buckingham that he runs a 17.906. So Jay Scott now into the top five. He goes fourth quick. Kenny Collins is now on the bubble with a 17.672. And Skinner is now on the top position for starting on the pole for the PPM Products B Mains. Next machine out of Soddy Daisy, Tennessee in the H3 machine. It's gonna be Kane Hickman. And behind him in the number 97, one of the Tennessee veterans up here in East Tennessee, it'll be Bobby Griffin. Bobby Griffin sporting the GRT race car to him, hoping to make it into the big dance tonight, but coming across the stripe first, Hickman hits it. 19.518 for Kane Hickman. And Bobby Griffin goes 9th quick with a 17.994. Hickman up top as he comes across the strike. 19.273 for Kane Hickman, his second go around. And Bobby Griffin, 18.371 on lap number two for him as he remains ninth quick. So fifth place, Kenny Collins. We will edge in and miss the hooligan races, known as PPM Product B Mains. In fifth, Jay Scott, fourth quick, third quick, Steven Roberts. Second quick, TJ Reed, and Tommy Kerr. Fast is so far with a 17.127. We'll see if that time can hold up. He will get the pole as far as starting order, but who will be overall fastest for the Nose Race Parts Fast Qualifier Award? So Sunoco Race Fuel time trials getting underway for group number two. Next machine out of Rome, Georgia, and the number 84 machine with the Clemens Race Engines under the hood, Capital Race Car. It'll be Austin Smith and coming up behind him. in the number 98 machine out of Hohenwald, Tennessee. It is EZ of Eric Hickerson. Austin Smith clocking in on his first lap, a 17.127. Oh, that's not the right time. Next two machines out onto the Speedway, coming across the strike. And the number 25, one of our Rookie of the Year contenders. Then the number 25, it'll be Joseph Faulkner. And rolling in behind him, and the number 21K, it'll be Dakota Knuckles. Faulkner clocking in with a 19.337 on his first go lap. So here we go. Group number two coming out onto the Speedway. On the number 25, it'll be Joseph Faulkner running for the DirtOnDirt.com Cruise with the Champions Rookie of the Year. And coming up behind him in the number 21K machine, it'll be Dakota Knuckles. .19455 for Faulkner on lap one. Good lap for Dakota Knuckles, a 17.710 for that young man in the 21K machine. On top of the board for group two so far. 18.682 for Faulkner as he picks it up on lap number two. 17.770 on lap two for Dakota Knuckles. So that will get those two in, then we're going to bring the other two back out for their qualifying efforts out of the 98 and 84 machine. Here we go in the number 98 machine out of the great state of Kentucky in the number 96. Already has a Southern All-Star win under his belt at the Duck River Raceway Park. It'll be Tanner English in the number 96 and coming up behind him. Out of Ottawa, Tennessee, in the R1 machine, the American Billet sponsored R1 of the four-time Southern All-Star Series champion of Riley Hickman. So Tanner English bringing it across, a 18.066 on lap one for Tanner English. Riley Hickman to the top of the board. The Hustler goes to the top with a 17.346. .17861 on lap number two for Tanner English. And a .17349 for Riley Hickman on that second go round. Not known for being a big track, high speed man. Good lap for Hickman, but we still got 10 cars to go. Next machine out in the Bear Ride Icon machine is Double T of Tommy Taylor. And coming up behind him in the number 50 machine. It'll be Van Lester making his first Southern All-Star appearance this season in the 50L. .18658 for Tommy Taylor on his first go around, and an 18.322 for Van Lester on his first go around. Tommy Taylor slows down to an 18.848 on lap two. And Van Lester slows down to an 18.424 on his second go around. Next machine out of the great state of Virginia, and the number 68 machine, it'll be Carter Miller, the 14-year-old phenom, making his first Southern All-Star appearance this season, and behind him, also making his first start with us in the 1G Warrior House car, it'll be flying Ryan King. Team 343 for Carter Miller, and he gets into the top five. Flying Ryan King, a nice lap for him, a 18.156 as he goes fourth quick. Track very slick right now. Carter Miller slows down to 18.589 on lap two for the Ironman champ. Nice lap for Ryan King, picking it up to a 18.066. He remains fourth quick. Van Lester right now, the man on the bubble with 18.322. Standing in between him and possibly having to go to PPM Products B mains. Next machine out, veteran driver here in the East Tennessee area in the C5 machine is gonna be David Crabtree. And coming up behind him, the Land and Air Trucking sponsor, number one Longhorn chassis Vic Hill race engines is going to be Vic the Thrill Hill. Crabtree, he's in the top five now. 18.301 for him so far. Vic Hill, third quick with a 17.753 for him. So Ryan King is now on the bubble. Crabtree slows down a tad bit to 18.431. Vic Hill slows down a tad bit on his second go around to a 17.877. So Vic the Thrill Hill now third quick, and Ryan King now is on the bubble with a 18.066. Next machine out in the 101 machine out of Toccoa, Georgia. And then Massey Electric sponsor, Cat sponsored machine. XR1 Rocket, it'll be Casey Roberts and behind him. Coming out of turns four in the 11B machine capital race car is gonna be Mr. Stacy Bowes. .17.466, Casey Roberts, second quick. Stacy Bowles, top five, .17.783. Roberts way up there in turns four, may have gotten a little bit of the wall. .19.519 for him, tough run, but still the lap was staying. 17.657 for Stacy Bowles. Goes third quick overall. Putting Vic Hill now in the bubble. So Casey Roberts second quick. Vic Hill fifth quick. Dakota Knuckles fourth quick. Stacy Bowles third quick. And Riley Hickman still on top of the board with a 17.346. Next machine out. Out of Rome, Georgia, the number 84 Capital Race Car, Clemens Race Engines under the hood. It'll be the young man of Austin Smith and coming up behind him. And the number 98 Masterbuilt Race Car out of Hohenwald, Tennessee. It'll be Eazy-E of Eric Hickerson. 18.115, not enough for Austin Smith. Same for Hickerson with an 18.413 as he goes 12th quick. Coming out of four, can Austin Smith pick it up from eighth quick? He does, six quick for him with a 17.778, just shy of missing Vic Hill's time. And a 18.654 for Eric Hickerson, he remains 12th quick.